Slow gospel music does not own the rights to the songs played. This is for ministry purposes only, not for profit, and is in accordance with fair use. The music on this program is credited to the owners and various companies.
SGM, we are thinking about you. Slow gospel music to soothe your mind and uplift your spirit. SGM, a voice in the wilderness. Prepare the way of the Lord. SGM.
It's slow gospel music and the unchanging word of God with Lester Suklau. Slow gospel music and the unchanging word of God with Lester Suklau.
My salvation, someone made in my story. Oh Yahweh, hope of nations, you've become my salvation.
Sing Yahweh.
It's slow gospel music and the unchanging word of God with Lester Suklau.
I want you to raise your hands in his presence and let's just worship God all over this room. Come on, everybody, let's worship God all over this room. this room. So we give you high praise and we say,
hallelujah.
You have won it all for me. Listen, I want you to lift your hands for just a moment. Let's worship God. I want to hear that guitar for just a moment. I just want you to minister. The Bible calls it a zamar praise. That praise upon the string instruments is that zamar praise. Glory to God. The Bible says that Saul called for David to offer a zamar praise when he was troubled with the spirit. There are some of you who are troubled in your spirit, but as we worship God in this fashion, God is going to set you free in your spirit.
Gospel music and the unchanging word of God with Lester Suklau.
Jehovah is Right out sake of truth and righteousness, let justice flow, 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 flow. Gird your sword, O mighty King, ride out victoriously.
It's slow gospel music and the unchanging word of God. With Lester Suplow.
Can you hear the music? Turn up my cans, y'all. Oh, oh, oh. Da, do, 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 do. I will bless the Lord forever. Trust him at all times. He has delivered me from all fear. He has set my feet upon rock. And I will not be moved. And I'll say of the Lord, you are my shield, my strength, my portion, deliverer, my shelter, strong tower, my veil. I desire besides you. Oh, you have made me glad. And I'll sing the Lord.
You are my shield and my strength.
My strength.
Oh,
It's slow gospel music and the unchanging word of God with Lester Suklau.
Somebody say hallelujah! Woo. You know, the Bible says in 1 John 3:1, see what great love the Father has lavished on us, that we should be called children of God. And that is what we are. Look at somebody next to you and say, that is who you are. Hallelujah.
Who you are.
sing all in one voice. Come on, you are perfect.
You are perfect in all of your ways.
You are
perfect in all of your ways.
Yes, you are, Jesus. You are perfect, you are
perfect in all of your ways.
With your hands lifted up,
perfect in all of your
with
ways.
An open heart, sing,
you are perfect in all of your ways.
Let's sing it one more time. Yeah.
You are perfect in all of your ways.
You are.
But a very pleasant good evening to one and all. I'm Lester Siglar, and a blessed Holy Thursday to each and every one of you, to those on radio, to those on YouTube, to those on Voscast. God bless all of you. It's good to be with you tonight. Yes. Tonight, as worship, the word, and prayer, as I get ready to hand over to Evangelist Anastasia Lee. Good evening to all of you.
Well, thank you, Jesus. There's no greater love than the love of our Father. No greater love.
Well, it's over to Evangelist Anastasia Lee, and good evening to all of you again. It's good to be with you this Thursday evening. Of course, we thank God for His Son, Jesus Christ. Indeed, He's a good, good Father. Thank you, Jesus, for who you are. He laid down His life and then took it up again.
The Bible says in 1 John 3.
Please stay with me. I'll be with you until 11:30. We've got lots in store for you tonight. Stay tuned to join in. We want you to join in for prayer. We want you to call in for prayer as well.
Look at somebody next to you and say that is.
It's over now to Bishop Frankie. And blessings to Pastor Mary. And blessings to Missionary Garvin. And of course, Evangelist Anastasia Lee. It's over now to Bishop Frankie.
Let's change the world. So many people are dying. Let's change the world. Hear out and crying.
Good evening, I'm Bishop Frankie Murren of Jesus Apostolic Ministry. Deliverance World Outreach on this program with Mr. Lester Siglar. Preach this gospel of Jesus Christ, the one is, always will be, and soon to even enter in our lives to make a difference. But to bring the word of God to us this evening is Evangelist Anastasia Lee. God bless her as she comes.
Hallelujah. Good evening and greetings to all those who are under the sound of my voice. I greet you all in no other name but in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Good evening to Minister Lester Siglar. We thank God one more time that we could be on Slow Gospel Music to let each and every one of you who are under the sound of our voices know that our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ is indeed the answer for the world today.
Yes, he is.
This evening we go to God's Word and we go to the book of Hebrews chapter 8 and we read verse 6. And the Bible says, "But now had he obtained a more excellent ministry, by how much also he is the mediator of a better covenant, which was established upon better promises." We thank God for His word this evening. Now the Bible says, "But now had he obtained a more excellent ministry." Mm-hmm. The Word of God lets us know that our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ came on the earth to do one thing, and that was to pay the price for mankind. He came so that each and every one of us as human beings could have a relationship with the God of the heavens. He came so that each and every one of us could have that opportunity to be reconciled back to God. But before our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ came, the Bible lets us know that there was a covenant. There was a covenant made with God and man. And that covenant, at that time, there was a high priest. And that high priest would stand between God and the people. He, at that point in time, was the mediator, a human being, a man who God would have set aside, whom God would have chosen to stand between him and the people. And that high priest would have made sacrifices for atonement for sin. At that point in time, there was no remission of sins as yet. At that point in time, human beings were not set free from the hands of the enemy completely. The Bible lets us know in the fullness of time, God sent his son, his only begotten son, Jesus Christ, who would not just fix the problem temporarily, but he would fix the problem permanently, once and for all. God had a plan not to just do it for one generation. He did not have a plan just to do it for two generations, but God had a plan to do it for mankind. He had a plan to pay the price for every single human being. And that is indeed what our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ came to do. He came, and the Bible lets us know that when he came, he laid his life down, knowing that he had the power to pick it up again. He laid his life down, so his life was now the sacrifice for sin. No longer was mankind the one standing between God and people. No longer was there a human being, a man, a high priest, but now there was the Son of God. Now was the Son of God a sin-free offering, someone who was holy, someone who was undefiled, the Bible says, someone who was the high priest that lives forever. The Bible lets us know in this same book of Hebrews that if the first covenant, if that high priest, that man from the beginning who was standing between God and the people, if that was faultless, then there would be no need for a second one. But because that first covenant had fault in it, that God had to be able to make it better for all of us as mankind. God had the perfect plan to set us free from sin once and for all. Not a normal human being, and not someone just going in once for a year to make things better, but the Son of God who would do it once, and he would do it for all. Because that high priest in that old covenant would have died at some point in time, and they would have needed someone else to come and be a high priest again. They would have needed another person to take the place of that high priest that passed away. I say to you, God didn't want that anymore. He didn't want someone having to come and do it again and over and over. The Bible lets us know that the high priest that we now have, the one who is now seated at the right hand of the Father, making intercession for you and I as human beings, he is a high priest that lives forever. The Bible said, but now he had obtained a more excellent ministry, by how much also is he the mediator of a better covenant. A better covenant, the Bible says, not that God doesn't do things decently and in order, not because God does things haphazardly, but because God was just getting us as human beings into a place to accept the fact that when Jesus Christ, when his life would become the ransom for us as human beings, that we would have that ability to believe, that we would have that ability to receive him as our Lord, to receive him as the one that laid his life down. I say to you, because he is not like the high priest of before, because he is not like normal human beings, because he is a different covenant, because it is a new and a better covenant, that is why we could come unto our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. That is why we could trust him with our life. That is why we could lay our life down and he would be able to take care of us. That is why the Bible says we could cast our cares on him because he careth for us. That is why the Bible says that we could come unto him, all you are labor and heavy laden, and I would give you rest. That is why we can do that, because now this high priest, the one who made the ultimate sacrifice, the one who paid the price for sin so that you and I could be set free from the hands of the enemy and no longer have to live in that place of bondage, in that place of being oppressed and depressed by the enemy, now we could be free. The Bible says, who the Son of Man sets free, he is free indeed. And I say to you that that is what Jesus Christ came to do. He came to pay the price. He came so that this covenant that God had in store for us, that this covenant could be a better one. And it was established, the Bible says, upon better promises. No longer human beings had to make sacrifices of our own in order for our sin to be covered. That does not have to happen anymore. But now the Bible said that Jesus Christ, that he is the one that laid his life down so that we could be set free. He is the one that made the ultimate sacrifice so that you and I as human beings could have the opportunity to be reconciled back to God, so that we could have the opportunity to have a relationship with the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. I say to you that each and every one of us, we have someone who is interceding on our behalf. We have someone who is seated at the right hand of the Father and making intercession for us as human beings. But how many of us are willing to believe that Jesus Christ is? How many of us are willing to believe and receive this sacrifice that was made? This person who loved us so much that he would give up his life so that we could have one. The Bible says, what manner of love is this that a father, what manner of love is this that this Father God that we have in heaven saw it fit to not leave us in our contaminated state, saw it fit to not leave us in our sinful state, but to do something about it. He loved us enough to make a decision, to make a decision to set us free, to make a decision to bring us out of that place that we found ourselves in. What manner of love is this that the God of the heavens decided that I would do something about human beings? I would not just leave them with this old covenant, but I would make a new one that whosoever believeth on Jesus Christ shall not be condemned. You shall not be perish. You shall not perish in everlasting flames, but you would have everlasting life if you believe on our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I say to you that the God of the heavens made a way where there seemed to be none. He made a way for us where it seemed to be none. When our backs were against the wall, the God of the heavens sent Jesus Christ so that you and I could have an opportunity to be reconciled and to have a relationship with God, to know what peace, what joy and satisfaction is. I say to all of you who are under the sound of my voice this evening, accept our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ today, because he is the true, the holy and the undefiled high priest who is making intercession for us. Hallelujah. Heavenly Father God Almighty, I thank you this evening for your word. Father, I thank you that you would have ministered in the capacity that you chose to. I pray God for every person that is under the sound of my voice, that as they would have heard your word, that they would harden not their hearts, but they would accept the gift that you would have given unto us, that gift of salvation, that they would accept it, that our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ became the ultimate sacrifice, and now that high priest that lives forever is making intercession for them. Father, in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, I thank you for deliverance and I thank you for salvation. In the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen and amen.
Want to thank you so much. God bless you richly. Okay, we're going to have to give those numbers now. Let me get those numbers for you.
It's Slow Gospel Music and the Unchanging Word of God with Lester Suklau.
Majesty, with your mighty hands.
Those numbers to call now are 742-7293, 742-7293, 742-7293, to get on to Evangelist Anastasia. That is 742-7293 or 756-6987, 756-6987. 756-6987. You can call now. Those numbers are WhatsApp as well, so please call Evangelist Anastasia. Call for prayer. 742-7293, 742-7293 or 756-6987, 756-6987. Those are the numbers to reach Evangelist Anastasia. All right, so please call 742-7293, 742-7293 or 756-6987, 756-6987. You can call now for prayer, for counseling. Let someone pray for you. You can call Evangelist Anastasia now, 756-6987. Coming up in just a bit, prayer for the nation. And of course, you can join them again on the second Saturday of next month, where Pastor Mary Maureen will be on. Okay, coming up shortly, prayer. We've got Missionary Garving still to come. So stay with us at Slow Gospel Music. We are broadcasting on radio, on YouTube, and on Voscast. I'm Lester Siglal, and a blessed Holy Week, Holy Thursday, and week, yes, to all of you. I may not do much greetings tonight because of time, so stay with me, but we'll be getting into prayer in just a bit. Okay, so I just want to say hello to Sister Jocelyn Charles. God bless you, Sister Jocelyn, Sister Donna Patrick, Charlene Samuel, Brother Terence Adams, Sister Gloria Frank, God bless Thomas Sandra, Sister Penny Khan, Sister Phyllis Lendo, Sister Kathy Mohammed, Sister Beverly Yonglai, Sister Jennifer Francois, Sister Yvette Nelson, Sister Florentina Kisun. God bless all of you. Christine Suber. Hello to you. Hello to Brother Ryan Ramu, Farisha. Hello to Brother Winston Johnson. Brother Nari Ramlakan. God bless you, Brother Nari. All of you. Sister Marilyn Frederick. Sister Judy Rugby. Florentina Kisun. Judy Rugby. God bless you, Sister Florentina. All of you. So please call those numbers now for prayer. Sister Pamela Jeffrey. Sister Petula Coker. Sister Gwinnett. God bless you, Sister Lamorel, Sister Paula Ryan, Natasha Glodden, Minister Beatrice Stewart, Anne-Marie Jacob, Sister Yvette, Sister Delbury, Sister Vashti Ali, Sister Genevieve Olsen-Louis in the U.S., Sister Rosalind Tewitt, Joseph Maloney, hello to you, Mrs. Emtaj, Donna Patrick, Apostle Bruce Mears, Jenny Lutchman. God bless all of you. Sister Shelley Brown, all of you, God bless you richly. Thank you so much for joining us tonight. Don't forget, we'll be with you. Please stay with me and be ministered to. It's Slow Gospel Music on this Thursday evening, this Holy Thursday. Okay? It's 1 minute after 10. Coming up in just a bit, prayer for the nation.
Majesty, with your mighty hands.
It's slow gospel music and the unchanging word of God with Lester Suklau.
Washed me white as snow. makes me thank you for the blood that washes my sins away. Thank you for the blood that heals my
broken. Well, we are standing by to get into a time of prayer. So please stay with us and be ministered to as we worship the word and prayer tonight. So stay with us and be ministered to.
Thank you for
Please stay with us and be ministered to as we get into a time of prayer tonight. We are standing by to start things off. It's important to pray. It's important to stand in the gap. Yeah, we know that the God we serve is a way maker. Yes? Apostle Bruce Mears, a pleasant good night to you.
Yeah, pleasant good night.
God bless. Hello to Minister Beatrice. Good night.
Good night, Brother Lester. Good night to you, everyone. Amen. Good night.
Amen. Praise God. So we want to start things off tonight with, of course, the body of Christ. We want to start with a prayer for unity in the body of Christ, and that we will really put aside our differences and titles and everything else that goes with it and really begin to work as a unit. Yeah? So we want to start things off with Minister Beatrice as she prays for the body of Christ, and following is Apostle Bruce Mears, and he will pray for the government, the opposition, ministers of cabinet, of course the president. So we want to start with Minister Beatrice. We want to get it right. Yes, Minister Beatrice, would you start things off tonight?
Yes. Hallelujah. Thank you, Brother Lester.
You're welcome.
Hallelujah. We thank you tonight, Father God Almighty. Oh, true and living God, faithful Father, Abba Father, hallelujah. We thank you tonight for this privilege that we can gather together, oh God, to just give you all the glory for being a faithful Father to us. Hallelujah, God, who answers prayer, true and living God. We come before you with a clean hands and a pure heart tonight, Lord. And we know that you will hear us. Hallelujah, for the mighty God we serve. Father, we lift up the body of Christ before you tonight, Lord. Father, you said if two shall agree in such an anything, it shall be done. You said before we call, you will answer. And while we are yet speaking, you said you will hear.
Yes.
And Father God,
yes,
we lift up the body of Christ. Called by your name, Father. You said upon this rock you build your church. And you said the gates of hell shall not prevail against your church, Father. Father, we come against the spirit of division, confusion, oh God, that may tend to come in the body of Christ, Father God. We break the spell of the enemy. Father God, oh, how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together. And Father, sometimes when we look, In the body of Christ, we see this unity. Father, we see fame and fortune and, oh God, lack of prayer. But tonight, Father, you said, oh God, if your people call by your name, Lord, we'll humble ourselves. If we will pray and seek, just seek your face and just turn. Lord, that word turn, if we will just turn from our wicked ways, Lord. You said you will hear from heaven, forgive our sin and heal our land. Our land need healing, Lord. And you are depending on us, the church, the body of Christ, to live in unity, to come together and be one, to fight these battles, oh God. Spirits of wickedness in high places.
Yes,
we pull them down in the name of Jesus. The spirit of pride and arrogance and division, Father, and self, oh God. Father, we pull it down, we bind it and cast it out, Lord.
Yes.
And hear the cry of your people. Have mercy upon us, Lord.
Yes.
Oh God, as we reach out, Lord, we are the ones to save the lost, and you are depending on us to be at one. Father, we declare unity tonight.
Yes, God.
We declare
yes.
love. We declare success. We declare favor.
Yes, God.
We declare, oh God, and we stand to minister your word, Lord, that sick bodies will be healed, demons will be cast out. If there's division, you cannot work. So we declare tonight unity and forgiveness in the body of Christ. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah.
Thank you so much, Minister Beatrice. God bless you richly. Thank you so much. If you want to stay on the line and agree with Apostle Bruce, you can
do that.
And coming up right after Pastor Gail, Apostle Bruce, good night. Go right ahead.
Yeah.
It's all yours.
Good night again to everyone.
Good night.
Go right ahead. Yes, go right ahead. Yes.
Almighty God, we know that you told us to come in your name, and we come in your name.
Yes.
We pray one for another. Pray for those in authority, that is your word.
Yes.
And if we pray your word, we will get the victory. Because the victory is when we ask, especially when you give us your word, to pray one for another. And I pray for those in authority in government all over the world. All over the world, I pray for those in authority. They make right decisions, oh God. I know, oh God, by the power of your Holy Spirit, we should turn things around with prayer. Because you said in your word, prayer changes things. And Lord, there is power in your name. And I pray for our government in Trinidad and the big one, that we will live a humble spiritual life. Lord, that we'll have the authority to pray, the authority to worship, the authority to serve you in spirit and in truth under a government that is led by prayer, because you said pray for those in authority. Pray for our Prime Minister, pray for our Cabinet Ministers, and we are praying, O God, in the mighty name of Jesus. You said ask and we shall receive. What could I ask for tonight? On behalf of all the brothers and sisters in Christ, we ask for God for unity in the body of the politicians, this is Trinidad and Tobago, both the opposition and both those in authority. Lord, we pray, God, you will move from person to person in all government offices and use them with a spiritual mindset to bring about peace in our land, a love in our land, understanding, Lord. And
yes,
we
God,
break
yes.
the spirit of socialism. We break the spirit of what it's trying to do to us in our country, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let the opposition and the government ministers come together with good plans, with good presentation for our Radimuya Satya. Let our president, oh God, of this land, Lord, bless that president right now. Bless the prime minister, bless Kamala, the opposition leader, and all those that are leading government, talk to them, Lord. You have the power. You have the authority. You have to give them the anointing to follow in righteousness and in peace. You have that, Lord. spread it among Jesus. Them. Cover them with the blood. I bind the evil spirits around Trinidad. Mm-hmm. I bind the negative thoughts of those. I bind it by faith because we have the power. I bind it in the east, in the west, in the north, and in the south. Every evil demon that wants to manifest itself against Trinidad and Tobago, we bind that spirit, Lord. The signs are showing, Lord. Keep us together as a people. And I thank you, Lord, for your hand being upon
Jesus
us.
Name.
In the name of Jesus. Even Amen. All leaders of the world. Lord, touch them in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you so much.
Amen.
Thank you so very much. God bless you. Thank you so much. And thank you so much, Apostle Bruce. Before I hand over to Pastor Gail.
Thank you.
Missionary Garvin, would you contact me on the same number? Missionary Garvin, if you can reach me on the same number you got me on a while ago, please do that now. Missionary Garvin, you can contact me at this time. Pastor Gail, as you pray for backsliders and the unsaved. Pastor Gail, it's all yours. Good night.
Good night, Pastor Lester. Heavenly Father, come before your throne, O God, as I approach your throne of grace and mercy, Lord Jesus. I bring before you, Almighty God, all the backsliders, O God, in this land, Father God. Father, for they once knew you, O God, as your Lord and Savior, Father. I ask your Holy Spirit to touch them, O God. Touch their lives wherever they may be, Lord Jesus. Send somebody, O God. Some soul, O God, who knows you, O God, to speak to them, to minister to them, O God.
Jesus.
To bring them back to you, Father God. Touch them wherever they may be, Lord Jesus. Cause them, O God, to be able to come back to you, Father.
Yes, God.
So these are not the days and the times, O God, to be away from you, Lord Jesus. But, Lord, you said the harvest is ready, O God. Deliver us of you, Father.
Yes.
And in your word, O God, I ask right now, Father, as you, O God, will touch them, O God. Cause something, O God, something, O God, to be able to bring them back to you. Bring memories back to them, Father. Bring something, O God, that you, O God, and only you can do for them. Do it, Lord. And when you do it, Lord, let them know, O God, that because and only because of you, it is done, Lord. And I thank you, O God, for saving and bringing those backsliders back to you, Father God. In no other name, but in Jesus' name, Father. I decree it's done and I call it forth, O God. And Father, even the saved, O God. Father, I thank you for the saved ones, O God. Father,
thank
I commit
you,
the saved ones in your hands, O God. And I ask
thank
your Holy
you,
Spirit to renew each and every one of us, O God. Mine, O God. Give them a clear clarification, O God, of your word, O God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Let your word, O God, that is hidden in our heart, come alive, O God.
Yes, Jesus.
Father God. I thank you, O God, for your word tonight, O God. Your word that changed lives, O God. Father, I want to just thank you tonight that that word, O God, your gift to your people, O God, a fresh word, a rhema word, O God, for such a
Jesus
time like
name.
This, O God.
Amen.
Even as each and every church, O God, and around the world, O God, celebrate Easter, Lord, Father God, this long holiday weekend, Father God. Cause them, O God, each and every person, O God, to really and truly sit, O God, and see, O God, what is the real purpose, O God, and what Easter is truly about, Lord.
Thank
Let
you,
each
Jesus.
And every life, O God, realize that it is not just about eat and drink, O God, and to have a good time, O God, but it is about the real Jesus, O God, the true Lord and Savior who died upon the cross of Calvary, O God.
Amen.
And Father, for that we give you praise tonight, O God. We give
praise
you thanks
God.
Tonight, Abba, Father. And Lord, I just want to say thank you, O God, for saving, for healing, and for delivering, O God, your people.
In Jesus' name.
And for bringing each and every one of us, O God.
Amen.
Save and unsave, O God, to know you, O God, as your personal Lord and Savior. Father, I thank you for it, O God. And I commit, O God, this nation, O God, in the palm of your hands, Father. And I say, fix it, Lord. Fix it, Lord, in no other name. But in Jesus' name, Father, let your will be done in this land, O God. Let your will be done, Father
Thank
God.
Thank you, Jesus.
In every life, O God.
Amen.
In no other name, but
Praise
Jesus'
God.
Name, Father.
Amen.
Thank
you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. On the line is Missionary Garvin. Maybe you can just agree in the background. Missionary Garvin, Good evening, it's all yours.
Good evening, Minister Lepton, thanks very much.
You're welcome. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Wonderful God. Father in heaven, this evening we come before you. In none other name but in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, giving you honor, glory, and praise. For you are God, and beside you there ain't no other God. Almighty God, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, I come before you and lift up the entire nation of the earth. Father, you sit high, but you look low because you are concerned about us so much more than we are concerned about ourselves. And you see the state that the earth is in right now. You would have created us, O God, in your image and after your own likeness, and you would have placed us here to have dominion. But in came sin and messed up mankind. But Father, in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, even on tonight, I pray that men, I pray that women, boys, girls, everywhere that are around the world is able to recognize that you are the God of the heavens, that you would have created us to accomplish kingdom purpose. Father, your word said that righteousness exalts a nation, but sin is a reproach to any people. And we see all that is happening. Your word said that a thief cometh not but for to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But our Lord Jesus continued to say that he came that we might have life and we might have it more abundantly. So that abundant life that you would have desired for us, Father, I pray that men is able to wake up to the reality and recognize who you are for real. I pray even right now, in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, that a spirit of salvation that is able to sweep over the of the people, of the faces of the earth, so that souls can be saved to serve you in spirit and in truth. For your word said the time has come and now is where the true worshippers ought to worship you in spirit and in truth. So I pray, O God, that we are able to rise up and be whom you would have created us to be and walk in the way that you would have us to walk, in dominion and power. And for this we give thee thanks in Jesus' name. Amen and amen.
Praise God. Thank you so much, Missionary Garvin. Thank you so much. God bless you. God bless you richly. Thank you so much, Pastor Gail. Thank you so much, Minister Beatrice. Thank you so much. And God bless you, all of you. Thank you so much. We continue in just a bit. So stay with us and thank you so very much. Please stay with us. Of course, we thank God for who He is. We thank God for Jesus Christ. I'm Lester Suplal. We continue in just a bit. It's Slow Gospel Music.
I was a wretch. I remember who I was. I was lost. I was blind. I was running out of time. And sin separated, the breach was far too wide. But from the far side of the chasm, you held me in your sight, and you made a way across the great divide. Left behind heaven's throne to build it here inside. Oh, and there at the cross, you paid the debt I owed. Broke my chains, freed my soul. For the first time I had hope. So thank you, Jesus, for the blood applied. Thank you, Jesus, it has won. Thank you.
It's slow gospel music and the unchanging word of God with Lester Suklau.
Is Pastor Tamara Allard, and good night to you, Pastor Allard.
Night, Brother Lester. Good night, everyone.
God bless you. Well, I know you were normally at the beginning, but nonetheless, we want to pray for the peace of Jerusalem. You know, the Bible says we ought to pray for. So I want you to do that, and then right after, Sister Marilyn Frederick will continue. So let me hand over to you at this time.
Thank you.
Yes.
Father, we give you thanks, we give you praise, we give you honor, we give you glory. You said to pray for the peace of Jerusalem. And Psalm 122 says, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of Jerusalem. Our feet shall stand within thy gates, O Jerusalem. Jerusalem is built, a city that is compact together. Whether the tribes go up, the tribes of the Lord, into the testimony of Israel. Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. And we are praying for the peace of Jerusalem as we do every single day in our ministry and in our private prayer. We pray, Lord Jesus, Lord, your will be done. Father, oh God, for the Jews, for your people, Lord, that God, you will be there, you will guide them, you will protect them, Lord. There are believers in Jerusalem, dear Father. And we ask you, Lord Father, the four corners of Jerusalem, Lord Father, Israel, Jerusalem, Lord, the surroundings, dear Father, the four corners. Lord Jesus, you take charge, take control. Cover your people, Lord, cover your people. Let there be peace, let there be peace, let there be peace. And let them obey you, Lord. Let them go closer to you. Let them draw closer to you, Lord. Let them have your heart, Lord. Let them be obedient to you, Lord. And let nothing else escalate higher than it is right now, dear Lord. We pray for the peace. We are obedient to you. You said to pray for the peace of Jerusalem so that we will prosper, Lord. And Lord, Jerusalem is your heartbeat. Jerusalem is your love, dear Father, Lord. And we stand in the gap tonight to pray for them, Lord. To pray for every Christian person, to pray for the unsaved ones, to pray, oh Father, for that war that is in dear Lord, Father, oh God. Lord, we pray, Lord, that you will cause peace to take place. Let peace reign inside their Jesus, Lord, in every area, in every county, in every city, in part of Israel, dear Lord, Father God. It's a time clock for us. It's a time clock for us, Lord. It's our eyes supposed to be on Israel, Father, Lord, on Jerusalem, Lord. So help us, dear Lord, as we stand in the gap and we pray for them. And we say, Lord, let your will be done. Have your divine will. Jehovah Shalom, Shalom, Shalom. Let Shalom, let peace be upon them. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen and amen.
Oh, thank you so much. Thank you so much, Pastor Tamara. God bless you richly. Thank you. Yes, thank you. Amen. Thank you so much. Praise God. That was Pastor Tamara Allard. And we thank God for her as well and her ministry. Amen. So we continue now. And want to hand over now to Sister Marilyn Frederick. A very pleasant good night to you, Sister Marilyn.
Good night to you, Brother Lester.
God bless you.
Thank God we are alive. We thank you, Lord, for waking us out of our beds. We give you praise, Lord. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, your name is to be praised. We thank you, Lord, for allowing us to see today a beautiful day. God, take care of all your servants' needs. Take away all the sadness, Lord, and the problems in our lives we face. Touch our lives with contentment. Bless our hearts with love and faith, and make us more like thee. Lord, help us not to go weary in well-doing. We keep our eyes on you and your word. We want to obey what the word says. Let us take warning. Do good. Respect our fellow men as we should. For the time is swiftly passing by. Let our light shine, Lord, unto others. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for hearing and answering us. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Brother Lester.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. God bless you, Sister Marilyn. Thank you. Amen. Praise God. Please stay with us. It's 10:43 as we continue. Okay. Praise God. Thank you so much. Praise God. Oh. Oh. Pastor Tamara, I got your message. Thank you so much. I got your message, and we will definitely remember the family in prayer as well. Thank you so much. Condolences to you, Pastor Tamara, and your family as well. Yes. Thank you so much for letting me know. Carlene, Sister Carlene T. Charles, Janelle, thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Okay? Thank you so much. Please stay with me and... I want to get into a short feature with Pastor Derek Rampersad. So stay with me, and then we'll hand over to Pastor Sian. He's going to pray as well. And then we've got Pastor Dorothy Johnson. Let me get into this message with Pastor Derek Rampersad.
Pastor Derek Rampersad of Unique Pentecostal Church, one of Coffee and Cooper Streets, San Fernando. My message, obedience to God brings blessings, and disobedience brings curses, taken from Deuteronomy 28. God gave the angels and man to choose right or wrong, good or evil, life or death, spiritually, as Deuteronomy 30 verse 15. How God made everything, Genesis 1:31 states, God made man and everything very good. Can people bring curses to themselves by disobedience? Well, Adam and Eve chose to listen to Satan's voice. Not only that, but John 3:19 declares man loved darkness rather than light. Furthermore, Satan deceives the whole world, as Revelation 12:9 states. In addition to that, the people who crucified Jesus said, let us be cursed and our children. What you do, it either blesses you or it curses you. Jesus said in Matthew 25:41, cursed be those who are not obedient into everlasting fire that was prepared for the devil and his angels. Again, obedience brings blessings and disobedience brings cursings. God puts a test on everyone. Imagine Joseph was tested by Potiphar's wife, and he said, why should I sin against God? But not only God, he would have sinned against Potiphar and his wife, and himself will be cursed. But scripture said God was with him. If God within you, then you would refrain from sinning. John 1:12 states, as many as received Jesus Christ, to them gave he power to become sons of God. Not only that, Romans 8:10 declares, as many as are led by the Spirit, they are the sons of God. On the other hand, many still unsaved and quoting scriptures, as Acts 16:16, the woman had a spirit of divination, followed Paul and said, these men bring salvation to you through Jesus Christ. But Jesus cast out the devil. It was cast out by Paul through Jesus Christ, and she lost her demonic powers. Again, blessings upon obedience to God and cursings upon disobedience. Live righteous, live holy, live pleasing to God. God richly bless you.
Thank you so much, Pastor Derek Rampersad. Thank you so much, and all those who went before, Pastor Gail, Apostle Bruce Mears, Minister Beatrice Stewart, Pastor Tamara Allard, Thank you so much. And I'm joined by Pastor Cian Smith out there in Seattle, Washington. Following Pastor Cian in a bit is Pastor Dorothy Johnson out there in the United Kingdom. I want to say a pleasant good night to you, Pastor Cian. God bless you, and it's all yours.
Yes, my brother. Thank you. A pleasant good night to all of you and all who's listening. May the Lord continue to bless you.
Amen.
May the Lord continue to shine His face upon our nation in these times that we are living in. And we pray that the Holy Spirit will continue to go reaching hearts and breaking boundaries in these times. Father, we display that Your name will be lifted up on the hearts of the young people, the young children, the old people. We pray, God, that every dissension, every tension, every ungodly act will come to justice, Father. And we pray, God, in the name of Jesus, that we bind the acts of the enemy over our nation, over the nations of the world, Father. We bind the acts of the enemy. And we pray right now that the power of God will flow through without hesitation, without hindrance. And we thank You, Lord Jesus, that You're already working before we even think about praying. You said in Your word, You'll never leave us or forsake us in these times, Father. But Your name will be lifted up.
Yes.
As we pray in the name of Jesus, we pray for peace. Peace between families. Peace between homes. Peace between villages. Peace between people. We pray for the spirit of hostility to be gone in the name of Jesus. We pray for the spirit of hatred and the spirit of war, spirit of anger and rage to be decreased in Jesus' name. And we thank You, God, for Your truth to rain down on Your people, Father. The good news is already to spread all around the world, Father. We know Your word has no. And we thank You, God, that all the quarrels and the anger and the rage that is raising up in, Father, we put this in Jesus. Father, we know who is behind that. Satan is behind that, and we bind them in the name that You're given us above all name, Father, that Your name will glorify Your word,
yes,
Father.
God, yes.
And we tell God that revenge comes from God and from man. And we pray this in Jesus' name, that Your position for this generation will continue to bring Your word forward in this generation, Father.
Yes, yes.
And Satan can't silence it, Father, because Your voice is bigger. In Jesus' name, amen.
Oh, praise God, praise God. Thank you so much, my dear brother. And you can join
Thank
Pastor
you.
Cian. Pastor Cian will be on this Saturday, fifth Saturday this month. So you can join him this Saturday, just after 10, here on Slow Gospel Music. Thank you so much, brother, and have a blessed night.
Amen. You too, brother. Love
Thank
you guys.
You.
Be blessed.
Love you
Bye.
Too. God bless. Bye-bye. That was Pastor Cian Smith out there in Seattle, Washington. Coming up shortly, we've got Pastor Dorothy Johnson. So please stay with us and be ministered to. Yes. And be ministered to. Coming up in just a bit, Pastor Dorothy Johnson. So stay with us and be ministered to. God is a great, great God as we continue to trust Him. Yes, in Jesus' name. I'm Lester Suglar, coming up shortly, Pastor Dorothy Johnson. So stay with us as we continue now. I want to thank all those who already texted. Thank you so much.
You called me out upon the wall.
I want to say hello to Dr. Jane C. Deno Gilbert. Blessings to Dr. Jane C. Deno Gilbert. Blessings to all those who are listening to us. Hello to those all over the world. We are broadcasting on radio, on Voscast, and on YouTube. Yes? So stay with us. Blessings to Dr. Jane C. Deno Gilbert, to all the members of Faith Life Ministries. Coming up shortly, Pastor Dorothy Johnson. Blessings to Brother Johnson. God bless you.
You called me out upon the waters, the great unknown, where feet may fail. And there I find You faith will stand.
Pray tonight on behalf of Dr. Jane Cidiano Gilbert. She is not on tonight, so I'm going to just pray as I wrap things up before Pastor Dorothy Johnson. And so, Heavenly Father, on this wonderful Thursday, we give thanks for the sacrificial love of Jesus and the redemption we find in His resurrection. Jesus, thank you for what you did on the cross for us, O God. Thank you because of love, your sacrificial love. Thank you for the gift of salvation and the promise of eternal life. Oh God, may our hearts overflow with gratitude. May our hearts overflow with praise, oh God. Oh, we thank you tonight as we remember your sacrifice. Oh God, Father, help us, oh God, tonight to recognize more so, even though we cannot begin to understand what was done, we can believe. We can believe, oh God. Thank you, Jesus. May the resurrection of Jesus inspire us to live with conviction, to share your love with others, and to walk in the light of truth. Grant us, Father, the grace to be faithful disciples, O God, as we follow you on this journey we call life. Thank you, O God. May we reflect, O God, the image of Christ in the earth. Thank you, O God. Minister to that person who needs to be saved, O God, that backslider who drifted away from you, O God. Thank you, Father, because of this, we can return to your throne of grace, your throne of mercy. Because of this, Father, lives can be saved. And we thank you for the resurrection power of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Christ, the risen Christ, the one who died and raised up his life. Thank you, O God, for the tomb is empty. Indeed, Christ is risen. In Jesus' name, thank you, O God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for your love. Thank you for we have hope. We have eternal life, O God. In Jesus' name. You said, O God, in your word in John chapter 10, verses 28 and 29, and I give unto them eternal life, and they shall never perish, neither shall anyone pluck them out of my hand. And then, Jesus, you made it clear. You went on to say, oh God, you went on to say, my Father which gave them me is greater than all, and no man can pluck them out of my hand. Isn't that something? No man is able to pluck them out of your hand. Thank you, oh God, oh wonderful God. Oh Father, we celebrate with joyful hearts, oh God, because you are alive. Thank you, for you are alive forevermore. We thank you, O God, for the relationship we have with you, Christ Jesus. As followers of Christ, as Jesus' followers, those who received you, thank you, O God. Christ in me, the hope of glory. And we thank you for this hope tonight. In Jesus' name, amen. Coming up right after this, Pastor Dorothy Johnson, so stay with us. The name of this one is You're Still God. He is indeed God of yesterday, today, and forever. That's the sure thing. That's the sure thing. For sure we know that.
When I'm left standing in the dark, and all I feel is my heart breaking, you're still reigning, you're still God. And when I feel the hope is fading, the heavy questions weigh so hard, and though my soul may feel forsaken, you're still reigning, you're still God. Though I can't see what's before me, I know that I can trust your heart, and this one truth will be my story, that you're still reigning, you're still God. I will declare that you are with me, though voices whisper that you're not. You never leave me nor forsake me, 'cause you still reign and you're still God. And though I can't see what's before,
I can trust your heart,
and this
Run out one more time. Wherever you are, you're still reigning, you're still God. I don't know what you're going through right now. You're still reigning, you're still God. You're not surprised by this pandemic, you still reign. You're still reigning, you're still God. You reign, you reign, you reign. You still reign, you're still God.
I tell you, he is still God, and we thank God for his son, Jesus Christ, who became the bridge, the gap, and the mediator between God and man, standing by his pastor, Dorothy Johnson. You know, there's a little story about this police officer who was patrolling on the night shift in a town somewhere in northern Great Britain. While patrolling, he heard a quivering sound, and there he saw a little boy in the shadow sitting on a doorstep with tears in his eyes rolling down his cheeks. You know, the little boy said, "I'm lost. Please take me home." The police began naming street after street, trying to find the boy where he lived, trying to help the boy find where he lived. And so the officer named the shops and the hotels in the area, but all without success. Then he remembered in the center of the town was a church with a large cross high above the surrounding city. The policeman pointed to it and said, "Do you live anywhere near that? Do you live anywhere near that?" The boy's face immediately got bright. He said, "Yes, sir. Yes, take me to the cross. I can find my way home from there." I say tonight, if you come to the cross, there is a way. Just like that little boy, take me to the cross and I'll find my way home. Jesus is the only hope for this world today. And if you are lost, the only way home is to come to the cross. The cross of Christ directs lost people to their eternal home. And that's the thing about it. Jesus didn't stay on a cross. He rose from the dead. God raised him from the dead. So I'm not speaking about a dead Christ. I'm speaking to you about a living Christ, the Lamb that was slain from the very foundation of the world. Amen. It's just about 10 minutes after 11. And online, on the line, is our dear friend and sister, Pastor Dorothy Johnson. I want to say a very pleasant good night and good morning, Pastor Dorothy. Blessings to Brother Johnson. It's all yours.
Thank you. Thank you, mighty man of God, Brother Lester. Thank you, Slow Gospel listeners, wherever you are.
Amen.
Blessings, blessings, blessings. It's a glorious time, a wonderful time in the history of the church. And we just want to celebrate. We are not saddened. We are made glad by what happened years and years ago around this time of the Christian calendar. And the Lord keep reminding me that we're quite traditional. We only look at Easter time to preach about Easter and Christmas time to preach about Christmas. But we must preach the word whenever and wherever. So you might hear me preaching this incident again when it's not Easter, because we are going to break and preach the word. But today, tonight we want to look at the garden, Matthew 26, 36 to 46. We want to look at the garden. There are many famous gardens. We can read of the New York Botanical Garden. That's in the US of A. The Garden by the Bay in Singapore. Kew Gardens, very famous here in England. There are many gardens across the world. Maybe where you live, there is a botanical garden, there is a garden. And gardens are places of tranquility. They are very serenic. They are scenic as well. A place of relaxation and refreshment. Many people go to the garden after the wedding to have a nice background, a nice photo. A well-kept garden is very attractive, and it's attention-grabbing for many, many, many people. They love a garden. We got to remember that man's first home in the book of Genesis was in the garden. Man's first place of worship was in the garden. First place of work. The Bible says, dress it and keep it. It was in the garden. Man's first place for surgical procedure. God caused a deep sleep to come upon Adam and took a rib and created the woman. First theater was in the garden. The first couple that fell in love in the garden. And the outdoor life is very intriguing. It's also a necessity for living. Hence our concern over the environment and life, or our existence. And we know that there is much been said about the environment and man's existence, or existence of humankind, and also for the animal species and all that. Jesus was faced with a very crucial moment in his life, a time when he wished those who knew him the most would be closest to him. People whom he spent a lot of time with would understand what was happening. However, it was not the case. Sometimes they did not have a clue. or at that time, they did not have a clue of what is going on. Jesus's life in the garden proved to be a place not of relaxation, not of comfort, not of pleasure, but rather contrary. At this point in his life, he had a dilemma. It was dire. It was life-changing. Something was about to shift and give way. Something was about to break. Although Jesus had prepared his disciple, but they did not pay attention to what he had to say over time. They did not believe. They didn't thought that he was serious. Luke 9:22, the Son of Man must suffer many terrible things, he said. He will be rejected by the elders and leading priests and the teachers of religious law. He will be killed. But, it doesn't stop there. On the third day, he will be raised from the dead. We thank God for that third day and the hope in the third day. He will be raised from the dead on the third day. Jesus also said in John 2:19, destroy the temple, this temple, and in the third day I would raise it up. By the way, the accusation and the accusers said he was guilty. In Mark 14:58, they used that as the accusation against Jesus. We heard him say, I will destroy the temple that is made with hands, and within 3 days I will build another temple without hand. Far contradictory to what Jesus said. Jesus said, you destroy this temple, and in 3 days I would rise again, or I would raise it up again. They said, I heard him say, I will destroy this temple. So they were speaking of the temple made with hand, and within 3 days I will build another. If you look, it's almost, but it's not what Jesus said. And that's what has happened over the years from creation, where the word has been twisted. I will build another made without hands. Jesus was going through anguish and pain. He was going through immense suffering. He was going through distress. He was distressed. He said, my soul is crushed with grief to the point of death. And this was within the context of a garden. You don't look for thought for such in a garden. You expect a place of tranquility, a place of relaxation, a place where Jesus often resorted to pray and to communicate with his Father. It was not a place of intense and severe sorrow and sadness. But this occasion, well, a crowd of 8 men were left at one point in the garden called Gethsemane, while Jesus took Peter, James, and John with him a little further. And Jesus himself left Peter, James, and John and went even a little further. Not everyone get to go everywhere. Jesus was the one who determined who went where. And he's still the one who determines in our life where we go and to what point. Yes, we have a part to play in that. But Jesus was the one who determined in the crowd of the disciples who went where. The same trio was on the Mount of Transfiguration, Peter, James, and John, where they saw Christ's glory. Could it be that's the reason why Jesus chose them at this point to go a bit further? They saw Christ being revealed in Matthew 17:4. Peter said, it's good for us to be here on the mountain. Let's build a memorial, 3 tabernacles, one for you, Jesus, one for Moses, one for Elijah. Peter did not realize what he was requesting. Tabernacles were temporary. Tabernacles were movable. But tabernacles must be carried, must be set up on this mantle. While that was good for Moses' era, while that was good for Elijah's era, it was not what Jesus wanted. It was not going to go into Jesus' time. He did not come to establish or to continue to establish what was temporary, what was dismantled, and what was dismantled and set up and dismantled and set up, or what was movable. He wanted his disciples to know of the transition from tabernacle to temple. You destroy this temple and give me 3 days to raise it up again, speaking of himself. I know we're talking about the garden. There's so much to establish to get into that garden. These three who heard God's voice, this is my beloved son, hear him. Matthew 17 and verse 5. Peter, who recognized him when he said, whom do men say that I am? Peter said, you are the Christ. Matthew 16, 16, the son of the living God. Some say Elijah. Some say Jeremiah, but you are the Christ. If you know who Jesus was, you also know why he came. Well, they should have known why he came. And that's what we want to establish. Jesus took them a bit further. He knew that they were clueless because he was God. But was he giving them an opportunity? An opportunity that he always gives all of us, an opportunity. They were quite intimate with him, an opportunity to share in his suffering, knowing, well, they should have known what would happen. In the garden, he took Peter, James, and John a little distance from the eight. By the way, it was eight, not nine. Remember, they were 12 disciples. Yes, eight, because Judas had gone to join another crowd. Judas saw some money in this. Judas struck a deal. He wanted more in the natural, more in the way of mammon, more than what Jesus had bargained or had given him, or was trying to give him eternal life. But Judas's mind was on something else. And Jesus had a conversation while in the garden. Father, if it was possible, let this cup of suffering be taken away from me. The garden is not a place, as I established earlier, that we really, really think about as a place of suffering. However, for Jesus it was, I want your will to be done, not my will. If it's my will, God, I would have liked the cup to be taken away. But no, not my will. The garden experience was horrible. Jesus said, skip if possible. Father, let this experience be skipped. Let's touch the skip button if possible. I want to skip it, but not really. Let my will be done, but your will, God, to be done in my life. He would have gone even further as he returned and found them asleep. Most likely, the eight had joined the three, or the three disciples joined the eight. It seems as they came together. It didn't seem as if Peter were a bit closer to Jesus and the eight was further. To me, I want to think that they came together. And Jesus said to them, for three times, couldn't you watch in the garden? Couldn't you pray in the garden? My soul is distressed. Not one of them was there agonizing and understanding what was happening. Yes, the disciples might have been tired from a hard day and were snoozing, and their eyes were heavy. But the leader is going to be betrayed and crucified. The leader is going to suffer cruel mocking and beating. He's going to suffer And yet they miss that moment and that opportunity to be right there, to be praying. Watch and pray, Jesus said unto them, that you would not enter into temptation. This is a moment for all of us to keep watching. Keep praying. Yes, the garden can be as a bittersweet place, a place of sweetness, a place of all the nice things that there is in life. But the garden can also be a place of bitterness, a place of anguish. And why did Jesus do all this? Not for himself, not because he wanted to be a hero, not because he wanted his name to resound throughout history to say, look at what I have done. My friend, it was done all because of you and me. He had us in mind. He had a bitter experience in the garden, all because he wanted you and I to have the best of experience in eternity. Oh, what a savior. I yes. trust that you would fall in love with him. In Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you,
Lord. Oh, thank you so much. Thank you so much for that word. Pastor Dorothy Johnson, out there in the UK. And we'll take a few calls at this time. Yes, we'll take a few calls now. You can call 657-3780. 657-3780. You can call that number. You can also call WhatsApp. The WhatsApp number is 1-866-776-4044. 776-4044. That's the WhatsApp number, and you can call the landline as well. 657-3780. 657-3780. Yes, hi, good night. Good night. Yes, hi, good night.
Good evening, sir.
Good night, yes, hi.
Good night.
Hello.
I'm calling from Nigeria.
Yes, Nigeria. Hello.
I want Pastor Johnson Nigeria. To pray for me.
Yes, Nigeria. Pastor Johnson, you can talk yes. to Pastor Johnson. Go right ahead.
Hello. God bless.
I want him to... Good evening. I want you to pray for me. I'm from Nigeria. I want you to pray for me, sir.
Yes. Any specific area?
I want God's favor and mercy all over my life.
God's favor and mercy.
Oh, yes.
Yes. Okay. Hallelujah. Amen. Oh, Father, we thank you, Lord Jesus. No distance in prayer.
Thank you, Lord.
What a privilege we have that we can be connected anywhere in this universe, the world that you Amen. Have made, and your people can be anywhere. And oh God, not only connect yes, with us, but connect with you, Amen. Divine God. With
Amen.
Sister Time. Oh God, Amen. For your favor and for your mercy. What a request.
Amen.
What a humility in our heart, Amen. My God. Father, I pray in Amen. The name of Jesus that you would grant unto Amen. Her more than she asks, think, or desire. Oh God, your favor
Amen.
That is already upon Amen. Will be manifested, oh God, in such a great way that she would know Amen. Without a shadow of a doubt that this is the divine hands of a mighty God in Amen. A family, in a home, Amen. In a situation, my God. Lord, open Amen. Closed doors for her, Lord God. Minister Amen. Unto her. Oh, Amen. My God, use her as an instrument for the honor and glory of Almighty God. Amen. Touch her by your divine power. Amen. Even now, in Amen. Jesus' name, Amen. Amen.
Amen. And amen. God bless you.
Thank you. What time is it in Nigeria now, if you don't mind me asking? What's the time there?
It is 4:29 a.m.
Okay. God bless you all there. Wow. God bless.
Amen. Yeah?
Thank you.
God bless you.
Okay. Keep listening. Amen. Thank you so much. God bless. Okay, connect with Pastor Dorothy now. The WhatsApp number, call Pastor Dorothy now for prayer. That is 776-4044. That's the WhatsApp number, 776-4044. You can also call the landline. That is 657-3780. 657-3780. So please call now for prayer. Yes, hello, good night. Good night. Hello, good
Hello?
Night. Good night.
Hello?
Good night. Speak to Pastor Dorothy. Speak to Pastor Dorothy, yes.
Hello.
Hello, good night.
Hello, God bless.
Good night. You know, God bless. Good night.
Yeah, we are hearing
good
you.
Good night.
Go right ahead. We are hearing you.
I'm calling for healing for my body. I have spasms in the neck with the thyroid. Hello?
Hello. I heard healing for the body. I didn't hear anything else after.
Yes.
Spasms,
in, okay. Spasms in the neck. And I have a thyroid.
Spasms.
Yeah. I have my stomach uncontrollable.
You having problems with the stomach as well?
Yes.
Okay, stomach.
Okay. Okay.
And hallelujah.
And I'm calling for prayer for my auntie, family.
Unsaved family. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Okay, Pastor Dorothy. Yeah? Okay.
Yes, yes, I got that. Oh, Father, we thank you that you are not weary of us. You never turn your back upon us. You never, Lord God, think that we are too burdensome and we are too needy. We thank you for the divine, Lord God, encounter that we have with you throughout time. We thank you, O God, for even this time of year that we are reminded, O God, of what you did for us, not just for our soul, but for our body, for healing, for deliverance. And here, my God, our sister is requesting for healing for souls, for healing for body, for the total work that was wrought at Calvary to be manifested in her life and the life of her family. And oh God, we thank you, Lord. We thank you that we can come boldly to the throne of grace and make our request known unto the living God, the God who hears and answers prayer. I pray against spasm. I pray against stomach problem. I pray for healing in her body. I pray for a divine touch. Lord God, I pray that the virtue of God would surge through her body from the crown of her head to the sole of her feet, that she would be made whole and healed by the power of God. For unsaved loved ones to whom, Lord God, she present tonight, Lord, to you, O God, in the name of Jesus. Set them free, mighty God, from the power and the bondage of sin. For this cause was the Son of God manifest to destroy all the works of the evil one. We thank you and we claim deliverance for all her family that are not saved, that they would turn and serve the living God. For every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess. May they confess now. May they bow now to the Lordship of Jesus Christ. Amen and amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
God bless you. Thank you.
Amen.
God bless you.
God bless you, yes. Hi, good night.
Hi, good night, Brother Lester. Good night, Pastor Dorothy. Thank you for coming on tonight. It's a blessing to have you on tonight. Your word was so powerful. You are welcome. Tonight, I'd just like to ask for prayer for my sister husband, for a closer walk with God and for him to really and truly accept Jesus in his life. In Jesus' name.
Hallelujah. Oh, Father, we thank you. We praise you. We praise you. In Jesus' name, we thank you for this prayer request. We thank you, Lord, for your daughter. We thank you for the burden that we carry, Lord, of prayer. And we can, Lord God, share that burden with each other. We can come, Lord Jesus, and bring our petition before you. We thank you, O God, not only just bring it to you. We know, God, that you are God that hears and answers prayers. Call upon me and I will show you great and mighty things that you know not of. We thank you, O God, for the great and mighty things that you are going to show us. We pray, O God, for my sisters, my sister's brother-in-law. We pray for him, O God, in the name of Jesus. We pray for his soul salvation. We pray, O God, that you would draw him out of darkness unto light, Lord God. This is one prayer request. We know that if we hear, pray, God, it's not contrary to the will of God, because you desire above all things that we walk in health and in the healing and in the strength of Almighty God with salvation. In the name of Jesus, you desire all men to be saved. And we are praying, O God, for his soul's salvation. We are praying that you would touch him by your power. Lord God, we pray for that drawing and that tugging and that pulling of the Holy Spirit from darkness unto light, from death to life, in the mighty name of Jesus. We give thanks. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Dorothy. Thank you, Pastor Dorothy, for that prayer. Yes. I know God will answer prayer. And have a blessed night, Amen. You and your family.
Thank you.
In Jesus' name.
Thank you.
You are so welcome. Okay, Amen. Bye-bye.
God bless.
Thank you. I'll take one more call tonight. We want to thank God for that timely message from Pastor Dorothy. May we continue to serve Jesus in spirit and in truth, and let others know about his unconditional love. Let's see. Yes. Hi. Good night. Good night.
God bless you. Thank you. God bless you.
Good night. Talk to Pastor Dorothy. Talk to Pastor Dorothy.
God bless.
God bless you too, Pastor.
Yes. What's your prayer request?
My prayer request is for my legs, and I'm not have no use to me right now.
Your legs?
I'm bedridden. I have no use for my legs. They're not working right now. We can't be my wife, Pastor. We understand I take it on too much, and I didn't move in to go nowhere. I didn't want anybody to come to check 90 and a weekend.
Yes.
That's the good for it. Right now, right, like, my whole body is real meager. And no feelings in my legs.
No feelings in your legs. Yeah. Okay.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Okay. So.
Hallelujah. Yeah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, blessed be the name of Jesus. Oh, we thank you, mighty God. We praise you. We give you glory and honor. Lord.
Yes, God, yes.
For this purpose was the Son of God, Lord God, crucified.
Yes.
For this purpose you came. For him, Lord, you die. For all of us, Lord, we thank you, mighty God, for dear brother. We thank you, Father, for his life. We thank you, God, for salvation plan. We thank you, O God, for deliverance. We thank you, O God, for wholeness and healing in his body. We thank you, mighty God, as he expressed, Lord God, his frustration, as he expressed, Lord, his need, as he expressed, Lord, his desire.
Yes.
As he expresses, oh God, yes. What is going on in his body. His legs not moving, the lack of sensation and feeling. Lord God, his entire body, Lord, being bedridden. We pray tonight, oh God, that you would touch him. Touch body, touch soul, touch spirit. Meet the needs of his life by the power of the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus. Pour in your healing touch. Lord, add sensation after sensation after sensation.
Yes, God.
And God,
yes.
While he's there looking, Lord God, for a one-time miracle, it might be, oh God, in stages. I pray, oh God, that you would touch him. I pray that he would understand the power of God at work in his life. I pray that he would be grateful. I pray that he would be, Lord God, express gratitude
to
an almighty God.
Yes,
I pray,
Father,
God, that you would by your power do the work in his life, Lord.
Yes, God,
encourage his heart. Lift the spirit. Lord God, I pray against depression. I pray against everything that come to torment his mind. Oh God, give him a song. Lord God, give him a word. Lord, anoint him from the front of his head to the sole of his feet with a yoke-breaking anointing, with a healing touch, with a healing power in the mighty name, above all name, the name of Jesus, for which demons tremble, for which, Lord God, demons must bow, for which, oh God, everything will give way to the name of Jesus. We call upon your name in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, for those, oh God, who felt disappointment because their call did not get through.
Yes,
oh God, we pray for them, Lord. We pray for those who need healing.
Yes, Jesus.
We pray for those who need miracle. We pray for those who need finances. We pray for those, oh God, who need salvation. We pray, oh God, for them tonight. We are praying, Lord Jesus, that you would enter into their situation, mighty God, and bring deliverance, and bring healing. Oh God, bring spiritual healing. Bring restoration, my God.
Yes, God. Touch
the grieving heart. Night, Lord. Oh God, pour yourself in the mighty name of Jesus.
Yes.
We give thanks.
Amen. Thank you so much. Yes, thank you so much. Thank you so much. God bless you. I'm going to take this last call, Pastor Dorothy. Good night.
Okay.
Good night, Pastor Dorothy.
Good night, good night.
Blessed Holy Tuesday to you. And I want to wish you all the best for the weekend. And thank you for that message. So often we do need to remind us of this kind of message. It always pays out in the end. I want to thank you for that. I just want you to remember me in prayer for a lower back pain. I keep nagging me all the time. Just because of a surgery that I did, you know, so it leaves me with a little pains now and again, you know. So just remember me in prayer for that.
Thank you, Lord. Oh, we bless your name, Jesus. We thank you, God, for your healing power. We thank you for the success of that surgery. We thank you for skills. The doctors, every surgeon. We thank you, my God, for my sister's life. We thank you, oh God, for her soul, for her body, for her mind. And we pray tonight your touch upon her back. Lord God, you are a God of completion. And the God who has begun the good work in her is able to complete it.
We
pray,
Father,
God, in the name of
Jesus,
that you come back. You bring about, Lord, complete
Lord,
healing.
Release.
That you'll be able to do things that she never
thought she could have done, oh God, without pain, in the name of Jesus.
Yes,
the
Lord.
Point of healing touch.
Thank
and
you,
your encouragement into the spirit. In the mighty name of Jesus,
name
we
of
give
Jesus.
Thanks, Lord. We thank you, O God, for every stripe and whipping
yes,
that you received, God,
yes,
was because
God.
Of us, for healing, for deliverance.
Yes,
and
God.
We claim
yes,
it.
Father.
Claim it.
Yes, God.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Sister Delty. Have a blessed night.
Thank you, and same to you.
Amen. Amen. Thank you so much, Pastor Dorothy. And Father, you continue to use Pastor Dorothy, O God, as she would pour out. You continue to refresh and renew, O God. Pour into her, O God. We thank you now for her and for what she is doing for your kingdom, O God. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you
yes,
so
Father,
much. Yes,
Father.
Yes,
I just want to pray.
Yes.
Praying to slow gospel music, Lord. We thank
yes.
you, God,
yes.
for such a powerful tool.
Thank
Lord
you,
God, we thank you, God, for Brother Lester. We thank you for using your servant
thank
as
you,
an
Jesus.
Encouragement to so many. Lord God, I pray
thank
that
you.
He would be encouraged himself.
Thank you, Jesus.
I pray, oh God, that he would be strengthened himself.
Yes.
Oh God, that he would be blessed himself in the mighty name of Jesus.
Yes.
May this gospel music, Lord God, as he touches the globe, may it go continue to go from strength
thank
to strength.
You, Jesus. Yes.
And may you continue to use it mightily in the mighty name of Jesus.
Jesus.
May souls continue to
yes,
be saved
yes, yes.
And delivered. All for the honor and glory of Almighty
God, yes.
God. We thank you for the upliftment. We thank you, O God, for your power that is at work to will and to do of your good pleasure.
Yes,
we
yes.
praise and we bless you, Lord God, in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. Thank you so
Amen.
Much. Thank you so much, Pastor Dorothy,
thank
and enjoy
you.
your day today. I know it's Friday. In your neck of the woods, it's Friday, yeah?
Thank you.
And we thank God so
it's
much.
Friday,
amen.
Neck of the woods.
A
it's
wonderful,
Friday.
Blessed Friday, yes. So thank you for the word until next month, and God bless you. Enjoy
thank
your weekend.
You.
And blessings to
thank
Brother
you.
Johnson. Blessings to Brother Johnson as well. God bless. Thank you. Okay, bye-bye. Until next month, bye-bye. Yes.
God bless you.
Yes. Okay, bye-bye. Thanks. Yes.
Bye-bye.
And that was Pastor Dorothy Johnson, one of our ministers here on Slow Gospel Music. It's just about 11:47. Yeah. You were listening tonight and you don't know Jesus.
Wonderful, merciful Savior.
Will you come to Jesus tonight? You heard the word of God.
Precious.
You heard that Jesus is the only answer, the only hope for this world. Jesus became the bridge, the gap, and the mediator between God and man. Will you receive Jesus tonight? It doesn't matter what color you are, your height. It doesn't matter if you are tall, you are short, you are black, you are white, you are fat, you are thin. It doesn't matter to God. He loves you. He cares for you so much. Will you come to Jesus tonight? He loves you so much. Why not say this prayer? If you desire to come to Jesus, say, Dear Jesus, I come before you now, asking you to forgive me for all the sins I've ever committed before you. I was born into sin, O God. And so I ask you to forgive me now. Forgive me of my sins. Come into my life, Jesus, and live in me as I live for you from this day on, Jesus. In your name I pray, Jesus. Amen. If you said this prayer, all of heaven is rejoicing now. What a good time to receive Jesus. Anytime is a good time to receive Christ. Maybe you're a backslider. If you said that prayer, all of heaven is rejoicing now. Maybe you're a backslider, you've drifted away. Why not come back to the Lord tonight? He loves you, He cares for you, and He's waiting for you. Like the prodigal son, will you say, I will arise? Will you say, I will arise and go to my Father? He's waiting for you. Why not rededicate your life tonight? Say, dear Jesus, I've drifted away. I went my own way. I've sinned against you. I ask you to forgive me. Restore my life, Jesus, as I live for you again. In your name I pray, Jesus, help me by your Spirit to serve you again in spirit and in truth. In your name I pray, Jesus. Amen. If you accepted Jesus as Savior, you rededicated your heart to the Lord, find yourself in a Bible-believing church that preaches and teaches Jesus Christ crucified, died, rose again, and He is now seated at the right hand of God the Father, making intercession for His people, and will return, maybe sooner than we think. If you cannot afford a Bible, call me in the week on 776-4044, 776-4044. That number is WhatsApp as well, and if you're outside of Trinidad and Tobago, it's 1-866-776-4044. And this program will stay up on YouTube. Okay, it will be on YouTube. If you are with us for the first time, you can go to our YouTube channel. Please go to our YouTube channel, subscribe, and tap on the little bell. That is Slow Gospel Music with Lester Suklal on YouTube. You can subscribe and tap on the little bell, so when we are on, you will be notified. That's one of our platforms. So please go on, search for Slow Gospel Music with Lester Suklal on YouTube. All you need to do is subscribe and tap on the little bell, okay? And you will be notified when we are on. Want to say hello to Sister Donna Gayadine, Sister Chrissy, Sister Memmi, Sister Vashti and family, Sister Gloria Muhammad, Sister Farida Muhammad. And if I missed your name tonight, I apologize, and I'll do my best to make up for it. Have a wonderful, blessed Good Friday. It's a blessed Friday. Amen. Have yourself a great day tomorrow. And of course, we'll be back with you on Saturday, glorious Saturday, from 8:30 p.m. again. Saturday and Sunday. I'm Lester Suklal, saying bye-bye for the moment. I want to thank all our pastors and ministers tonight. Those who ministered, all those who prayed, thank you so much. Those who joined in with us to pray, to believe God, thank you so much. God bless you, Slow Gospel Music family, listeners. I love you. Lester Suklal, saying bye-bye for the moment until Saturday. Have a great day tomorrow. And be safe if you're going to be out. Be safe, okay, if you're in the house of the Lord. Bless God. And if you're going to be out, just be safe, okay? I'll be with you on Saturday from 8:30 p.m. I love you. Have a great and a wonderful night. In Jesus' name, as I leave you with this one, wonderful, merciful Savior, I'm Lester Suklal. I love you all. Have a great night. Bye-bye.